Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk about butane and butane's conformations. So again, I have gone to an earlier slide, our slide on ethane, simply crossed out ethane, changed it to butane, and now we've made a couple tweaks to make this slide work for our discussion of butane. My emphasis is it's the same discussion. Newman projections all kind of follow the same line of thinking. So we have we're looking at not ethane anymore. This is the sawhorse diagram of ethane, but we're looking at butane, and all we've done is put in methyl groups in place of these two hydrogens. So I'm going to go up to our top left Newman projection. I'm going to label these methyl groups as points of reference, and this is going to set us up to have a dihedral angle of 0 degrees. This is an eclipsed conformation, and we can predict the energy of this. We know we have some eclipsing interactions. These are torsional strain between these two hydrogens. These two hydrogens are 1.0. As it turns out, our two methyl groups, when we eclipse these, they have generate a lot of strain. It's not just torsional, it's also steric. So let's see if I can write this in here. Torsional plus sterics. And sterics arise when groups physically come in contact with each other. So I'm going to go down to our bottom picture, bottom left, and these methyl groups, they're pretty big, and they actually kind of bang into each other, and that's a high energy state. The energetic cost of eclipsing these two methyl groups is 3.0 kcals per mole. It's a combination of torsional strain and steric strain. That gives us a total energy for that eclipse conformation of 5 kcals per mole. Now, as we open up our dihedral angle between these two methyl groups to 60 degrees, we alleviate all the torsional strain, but we still get these methyl groups. They're still big enough to bang into each other a little bit next door. And that actually has more steric strain, and it has an energetic cost of about 0.9 kcals per mole. So when we go on our graph at 60 degrees, we're not going to go all the way down to zero. We're going to go down to about 0.9. And this is called the gauche conformation of butane when we have a dihedral of 60 degrees. Now, as we continue to open up our dihedral angle, looking in reference to the two methyl groups, we again encounter more strain energy. We get torsional strain by eclipsing these two hydrogens. That's 1.0. And from propane, we know that eclipsing a hydrogen and a methyl, each of those is worth 1.3. So our total energy is 1.3 plus 1.3 plus 1.0. That gets us 3.6, and I'm going to estimate that's about there. And now once we open this up finally to 180, we get a new staggered conformation. This is referred to as the anti-conformation because the methyl groups are anti to each other. They're on the opposite face of the molecule. And now we've alleviated all strain and we get down to our zero relative energy. So our curve becomes a little bit more interesting, but it reflects this combination of torsional strain and this new idea of steric strain. So the steric cost of having two gauche methyl groups is 0.9 kcals per mole, and we saw that up here. And if we eclipse two methyl groups, we get a combination of torsional and steric strain of 3.0 kcals per mole in our molecule of butane.